Now this week might be one of my best and most fun test drives because after all, it's one of my own. Hey, welcome to this edition of Road Warrior. I'm your host, Grant Robertson. Now this week I compare the old with the new, specifically my own Mazda CX-9 with the current 2019. Now, one point of disclosure, Mazda in my family is a tradition. My father owning the B2000 pickup truck decades ago. Fast forward to the CX-9 he passed down to me, it being about 12 years old and barely showing any signs of age. But sometimes the new shows up just for comparison's sake. Now, this being the 2019, obviously you can see that there's been a retooling and it's done quite well in mastering what it came from to delivering a little bit more cutting edge. So what we're going to do today is just see, well, how far we've come in the evolution. Now this 2007 has really been a reliable workhorse. When it was handed over to me about midway through its life cycle, well, barely any maintenance had been done, and well, that continued the standard course, only with just a tire replacement to note. Now this one still has some low miles, under 100,000, with barely again any external wear, and on the inside holding up just the same. So let's look at, well, the finer details. Now first off is grille warfare. Now this crossover like vehicle really doesn't need to have any kind of prowess. It doesn't want to kind of argue or growl at the big boys like the trucks or bigger SUVs. It just kind of wants to blend in and say, hey, we're crossing over into your territory. And you can see that from where we began. Just a nice modest grille, decent headlights that were starting to evolve, no longer just square designs, but simply giving a little bit more stylizing to the outer corners. Now fast forward to 2019, where we're definitely changing what the grille warfare means when it comes to crossover vehicles like this. The competition no longer with SUVs or the big boys, but maybe cool sedans. This front end definitely going out of the competition when it comes to cars, not SUVs. And you see it kind of in this very dynamic protruding front end. That compared to kind of more tight body lines. This a lot more dynamic, specifically even when it comes to the headlights. Headlights back then, a little bit more broad. Now, just a grimacing, almost squinting at you front end. Not to minimize that, well, the headlights aren't dynamic, because definitely they are, giving tons of forward headlight. Even better, of course, they're dynamic. Sweeping through the turns, and even better, auto sensing when it comes to brights, having them on and turning off when they need. As for the rest, body color all the way around, like we remember, as well as some added accents like chrome. Now back then, just some modest chrome around the hood itself and so on. Now with this huge amount of sweep down, really like a kind of growling front end. Nice lower air intake, but again, the fronts are really, well, being more dynamic from the good old days. Now for comparison's sake, these two vehicles are really at the same premium level, really delivering at the time the top of what they offer. Now first off, it's really on the outside of each vehicle. That one being traditional when it comes to access, the good old traditional key and key fob. This one being a little bit more innovative when it comes to smart key systems. And of course, that was not really the case 12 years ago. And it starts all right here on the outside. Now, the only thing the CX-9 now still falls short at is really the access point at any of the four doors. Instead, it's simply at the front. And I just prefer really this simple button to be added at every access. But either way, it's still easy. Just simply walk right up, press the button one time, and all the doors unlock with ease. If you need to lock it up, just simply press it again and walk away. What's great is when you press it, you'll tell it's locked because obviously the audible noise, but also these particular mirrors fold in. So if you're walking away, press the button, you can definitely tell it is locked up. Like any of us, when we are a big fan of a certain model, we've really held on to it for, like I've had, more than a decade, you definitely don't want to see it reinvent itself. And that's what the CX-9 has done. It's held on to its silhouette. It's held on to its true design points with, again, certain enhancements that really just take it to the current evolution of the vehicle. Now, what they've also held on to is its roots. And what I'm thinking of is really just nice and basic. And where it starts is here at the fill-up area. One thing vehicles aren't doing is, well, securing this right here. And what Mazda did, well, they didn't rethink this part. They kept it the same in the form of a release pull there by the driver. That pretty much is going to unlock this fill-up area. Even better, kept it traditional when it came to the cap with just a simple cap system. Swinging around to the back end, really the CX-9 hasn't changed that much, with just a little bit more sculpting and refinement that has occurred since this 2007. You'll see it in the extension of the rear roof spoiler, extending out just a hair more, a little bit more design through the middle, while this one's pretty much plain Jane straightforward, as well as the taillights receiving a lot more attention when it comes to sculpting versus the wraparound old school look like you see here. As for the rest, body color all the way around these vehicles, similar accents when it comes to the chrome trim around the windows, not to mention the lower cladding that pretty much surrounds the vehicle. What I like is the holding on to those key features. This specifically minimizing scrapes and dings and really sets off the design, giving you some contrast between the accents and the body color. Now, when it comes to operation, my particular vehicle pretty much was the manual when it came to the hatch. But of course, for 2019 on this premium specific model, well, it's gonna be a powering affair. Simply press it one time and it really gets out of the way. And what I like is it has some decent get up and go. As for the overall height on the outer portion, a little bit low, but what you'll notice is it actually arches here in the middle, obviously mimicking the contour of the back end. This giving you just a little bit more height here in the middle. Now, it's great with the CX-9s, it hasn't had any growing pains, feeling like it needed to be bigger or smaller as it's compared to the competition. Instead, holding on to the numbers from whence it came. Now, what you're gonna see overall is still around about 199 inches. The only true difference may be in the wheelbase, growing from 113 to 115 inches, like you see here. As for the rest, pretty much dead on numbers. The height, around about 69 inches, width, around about 77. Those within a fraction of what lies behind me. Now, one other big number is ground clearance, growing just a hair from 8.1 inches to around about 8.8 inches as you see it. Tradition may be the name of the game for the CX-9, and you see it both in this trim I mentioned earlier, but also maybe at the four corners. Now, my specific model had 18-inch wheels, this one having 20 with a little bit more low-profile tire. But what they held on to? Possibly the rim design. Now, that's just a hair different, but the 10 spoke is still there, both on the old and the new. A little bit of family tradition never hurt. Swinging around back to the business end of the CX-9, this is where things need to measure up when it comes to cargo and delivering both people and their gear. Now, first off, I didn't mention the safety, but let's look back here. Compared to 2007, didn't have what we see: backup sensors, backup camera. That's just what's great with innovations. Standard safety pretty much coming on these vehicles, just unheard of back then. Now, as for the interior, what you're gonna see now is around about 14 cubic feet. Comparative, it was a little bit more like 17 on the previous model. So skimping just a hair, but not a big difference. Now, what you're gonna see is a little bit more ease when changing over. Really just a little bit in design features, just a hair. Now, what you see instead now is just a handle. It tumbles these forward with ease. Really nice and simple. Now, once these are laid flat, what you're gonna see is around about 38 cubic feet. Now, really giving us similar numbers really moving forward. One great feature they did not get rid of is these outer niches here at the back end. And what is that great for? Well, longer items, but specifically the golf bag. Simply going to hit the links, simply put it right across here with ease. Now, obviously, with the third row laid flat, allows you tons of cargo options. One place that not all vehicles are created equal, but CX-9 continues to deliver from 2007 to current, is right beneath the cargo floor. And first off, once you get it up out of the way, what you're gonna see is this lower compartment, really easy to store items if you prefer. But what you're also gonna see is, most importantly, a nice full-size spare. And even better, nice subwoofer positioned in the middle. Now, one area you may see a big difference is really under the hood. No longer is it the V6, but going more with a four-cylinder, but adding some turbo power. Now, specifically, this is a 2.5 liter. Now, it's gonna deliver around about 250 horses and 310 foot-pounds of torque, easily outshining what I recall. Now, it is coupled with a nice six-speed automatic transmission and really makes for a nice quiet ride with just enough get up and go. The biggest change for the CX-9 comparative to the 2007 has to be on the inside with innovation taking center stage. Now, one thing it really held on to is the styling when it came to the seats. Really nice and comfortable, bolster but not too tight, really mimicking from whence it came. Now, of course, these are even better as plush and really comfortable. Now, this particular model did have powered front passenger and driver seats. Now, the biggest conversation has to be there right in the middle, really when it comes to this screen up top and the control knob in the middle.
The biggest difference between now and then is, well, front and center on the dash in the form of this huge oversized touchscreen system. Now, one thing to note, it is touchscreen, but it is kind of an arm stretch away. And the way they fix that, well, is simply by adding a central control knob. This is obviously taking this vehicle to the next level. Now, what's great is this is standard across the board when it comes to CX-9. You also see it on the CX-5 as well. Pretty easy to use, nice turn knob, toggle up and down, really interacts with the screen up above real easily. Now, what you do is simply use the knob to select what you're looking for. And what I like on this is really the tune select. Now, once you press it, you'll get to this dial ability that you see on the screen. This kind of a throwback Thursday, going to just the good old dialing in your specific setting. Now, there is satellite as well as Bluetooth connectivity and all the Android and Apple devices you could use. But what's great is they've really evolved this vehicle from what I remember to an innovation hub. So looking at this area a little bit deeper, one thing you'll see is the shortcuts, especially if you want to get to maybe the navigation or the music. Well, they put those nice and easy to get to. Now, if you get lost, you simply press the home. That's going to take you to various settings that really allowed the knob to dial in with ease. Now, what you also see is a back button. So when you get to certain menu selects, you can press that. Even better is the volume knob is barely an elbow stretch away, really allowing you to turn it up and down real simple. For the gauge clutch, you're going to find an analog tachometer, but a digital version in the middle. Now, it's going to be a nice integrated LCD screen that really gives you lots of information. Now, you can simply kind of go through it with these by pressing the info button there on the steering wheel. Now, one thing to note is pretty much it does have the digital analog, and about that is the only digital readout you'll get here. But one cool feature is it does have heads-up display, which allows you to get that digital readout there on the windshield.
On the left side of the dash is where you're going to find some other features you can toggle on and off, specifically the parking sensors. You can turn on the camera with the press of a button here, relates to the center screen, as well as the lane departure system. Now, this is really great to use when you're trying to maybe just stay within your lane, allow the vehicle to assist you. But if that becomes aggravating, you can simply turn it off.
Adaptive cruise control is a nice feature, and it is on this particular model. And now what's great is you can set the spacing between the cars in front of you, easily set the cruise right here, and toggle it on off with these buttons. Dual cup holders are between the front occupants, have these nice spring-loaded little grippers, hold any size drink with these. You also find a deep center console split in the middle and connectivity with two USB connections and an auxiliary jack.
If you need an additional power supply, you'll find a traditional outlet on the passenger side, real easy to access there by their left knee. Entertainment is the name of the game here in the second row, and it's built in the form of these TVs mounted to the headrest. Now, what you also find is just standard comfort, and this is really what's continued from 2007 to the current model, really in the form of this nice bench styling across the second row. Nice spacing when it comes to the floor, really just a modest little hump there in the middle, but no real battle 4 feet position. Now, this is a tri-zone system, which is to be expected for any three-row vehicle, with back seat outer passengers really getting heated seats, but anyone can really take control of the climate and nice vents to make sure it flows back. One area to help keep things cooled down is, well, the nice window shade. And what you'll notice is it's a very broad window here at the back end, huge amount of door. And that means, well, that's a huge amount of glass. So this nice window screen can really be brought up to, well, darken things out and cool it down in the summer. To grant access to the nosebleed section, one thing you gotta do is just simply reach up here to the shoulder handle, pull one time, tumble it forward, then slide the seat forward. Now, all you got to do is simply look down and notice it's a nice aisle there to the third row, and pretty decent comfort in the form of two areas for passengers, and basically nice overall cushioning. And that does it for this edition of Road Warrior and a test drive behind the wheel of the 2019 Mazda CX-9, a vehicle that has definitely grown gracefully over the last 12 years, really only adding some enhancements, not forgetting its base design. And that's the key feature with Mazda, is they're not reinventing the wheel, but really starting from a great point and only adding enhancements. And with time comes great innovations when it comes to safety, security, and, well, even better, entertainment. Now, as always, like, thank you for watching this edition of Road Warrior. Keep both hands on the wheel and eyes straight ahead.